a very easy lane. I think he has a lot of easy targets he can just jump on. Lina's gonna be fragile. She's a support. Same goes for Q on the Wyvern. I have a feeling EG are feeling pretty confident going into this game, feeling pretty good. They're up one game. I personally favor their draft, unless if CDC get off to a really good start and start taking towers with Dragon Knight.
CDC actually have a lot of things they can work with in the early phases. Because if they do get a good start, if you look for maybe the more aggressive DK we've been seeing throughout the TI5, which is with the Blink Dagger for the Dragon Knight, so you're able to jump in, you get that initiation, maybe Garda in combination with the Wyvern, where you have Curse as well as that Laguna Blade, Storm Spirit jumps in, you instantly control, you instantly nuke him down, and then the rest of the work has to be done by EG. Like, there's a lot of things that Cedar can work with, and then you've still got Aggressive's PL. Never underestimate his Phantom Lancer.
EG have beaten it today, though.
They have.
Keep in mind, Aggressive did lose his first PL game.
I will not deny that one. At the same time, with so much on the line, you can succumb to pressure every now and then. So our early laning phase is going to be pretty passive again, primarily just because we're just waiting for the runes right now. But Samael, you say you should be having a very easy lane up against the DK. How does T-Deck now try and counter this? Do you rotate more supports in?
They could look to gank him early on, but they can't focus on him too much because then we get a situation similar to game one where they're emphasizing the mid lane so much that EG just stack the jungle a lot and Samael comes back that way. In a way, the most important thing for them is to secure the PL, his farm, and make sure Clockwork gets level 6 so that they have some sort of counter initiation when Storm just jumps on his target. A Blink Dagger on DK and a Clock Hook are decent tools at dealing with Samael in the mid game. But it's not going to be easy for Dragon Knight. He's not even going to get a 1-on-1 lane. It's going to be a 2-on-2.
AUI is going to add a little bit more pressure up against Cheeky in the early stages. And what's Garda really going to do against this as well? Like, he wants to come in close, but then he's going to be the one to get Riptided up and just forced out of the lane. But we've got the bottle already arriving for the Dragon Knight, so this is fine. The DK is just able to farm with most of, like, green fire harassing the Samael. It's not like it's a Templar Assassin. It's going to have defensive refraction charges that can avoid the damage as well. So that's fine, and both teams are looking to now do their pulls. The Observer Ward's already up for EG, which is also blocking up the pull point. This Sentry Ward is only millimeters away from actually getting the D Ward out. And on top of that, CDEC can't even pull the side camp because that's also blocked up by another Sentry Ward. There's just no way for CDEC to throttle this lane out and stop Universe from finding experience. And now you should actually probably, like, what even do? You've committed one of your Sentry Wards. How do you even stop this now?
I think they might need to smoke and look to rotate and gank the mid lane first. And then if that gank is successful, they can buy sentries and maybe go back up and pull. This is definitely not a good start for them.
While PPD is able to do his pull on the bot lane.
They actually gave the other sentry to XC. That's why they can't counter the Observer Ward. With one sentry, there is a risk you don't find it. And the one he has placed for the Rune Ward is really doing anything.
Battery Assault on PPD. Does he have enough life to survive this? He went Chilling Touch to start with, and Fear is making his way over. And this Rocket Barrage will be forcing Clockwork out if he kept pushing it out. But at the same time, he realized now there's a regeneration rune at bottom. Pick that one up and be good to go. Regeneration!
And Dragon Knight got the top rune. This means no rune for Samael this time. He's just gonna Bottle Crow.
At the same time, Samael has completely crushed this lane. He's 14-8 up against 5-0 on the CS. This Dragon Knight has found no space whatsoever.
It is a very difficult lane for Dragon Knight. This is nothing out of the ordinary. Although, Cheeky, in other matchups, he's played like Dragon Knight versus Shadow Fiend, I think, where he did exceptionally well. But Samael Storm is very difficult to play a melee hero against here in the lane. So he's going to be getting 9 CS here if he gets both of them, which it looks like he will. There we go. So he's 9 against 17. That is definitely not that good, but it's to be expected. Also with AUI putting a little bit of pressure in there with the Naga. So with the Knight and a bit of CS.
Should also flag the fact that C-Deck is starting to stack up inside their camps. So we've got a triple stack inside the Dire Jungle, which we flash farmed up later. And DK is able to do that one. Lina would obviously help out with Light Strike at Rand. That'll give her burst in levels. And you can see that Laguna Blade coming a little bit earlier. And also the Dragon Knight progression of items coming a lot faster too. That's something the Storm Spirit can do, but currently there's actually one stack in the lane, in the jungle, so that's fine. Actually, there's two of them. So there's two double stacks available for Evil Geniuses. I'm gonna keep my eyes on that one, considering what happened last time we had our Storm Sumail. And Universe has also managed to find a lot of levels. Both the Clockwork as well as the Earthshaker. But we've got three on the Clockwork, four over on the Earthshaker. And in fact, Universe completes his Soul Ring as well. This will stop practically any push in the lane, and he's actually using the Fissure as well to block up his Creep Wave for the moment. It's actually not going to stop the balance of the lane, because the Catapult's still in there.
This early game laning stage definitely favoring EG. It's what they want. If they can get a slow laning stage where both their AA and their Naga Siren can pull, get experience, and the enemy team can't, and they have a favorable matchup mid, and they have free farm on Fear, and they're getting a lot of experience on Universe, this is exactly as planned for Evil Geniuses. But they still need to be careful, of course, as heroes start to go missing, and they don't really know exactly what the supports of the Dire are doing, so Universe is going to stand far back, and now they do. Okay. They actually still have that ward, which is giving them so much information. If they smoke now, that would be a pretty big mistake. They obviously realize that is not the play to make right now, as their camp is still blocked. It has to be an observer ward. Mm-hmm. They just pick it up on Garter, who's probably going to stack, and then maybe they will look to make their play. And it's not like they're falling very far behind on gold. The experience is 1,000, which is decent. It's just the implications on the game. Like, it's playing in EG's hand, I feel.
But it's what all that burst gold's going to do for them. And we talk about it being 1,000 gold. In fact, the net worth is 100% less on zero, and the experience is just up for EG. But it's once you take out the quad as well as the trip stack, it's very simple for the DK then. Well, he's already got level 6. He can add pressure in towards the tower. There's things which CDEC can do. They don't just have to sit in the back lines and wait it out until EG make a play before Sumail with his level 6 tries to make a bit of a jump. Which is also possible. But another reason too why CDEC cannot fight. You don't have level 6 over on XE, so there's no Clockwork hookshot up just yet. The Lina is in no position to get in and start any kind of engagement. She's still waiting for the DK to come up and flash farm. Then they can give the space to the Winter Wyvern so he can get up to his curse, his level 6. Alright, so we got the double quad stacks ready to be farmed. This should be really quick and fast levels for Garter and really good money for CDEC.
They're gonna need to wait for another Breathe Fire to do this one. At the same time, for Evil Geniuses, they do their quad stack. They give it to Fear, actually. I thought they were gonna give it to Sumail, but he takes the other big camp, which I do believe was just a double. That's gonna push them both forward very nicely for some good experience here. And gold, of course. And what did Garter accomplish? He got level 3 from that stack. Okay, there's still a little bit of it left. He's going to get 3.5.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And this is only one of the stacks that CDEC prepared. So they can do the other ones. The issue is Shiki doesn't have any more mana for it.
And it's double golems. So that's going to take them forever. They actually got pretty unlucky there on the RNG. Aggressive's finding good farm though. So this is the standard start that CDEC have been aiming for whenever they have their PL. They just want Aggressive to have a one-on-one in the safe lane, their supports to move. Now because they couldn't pull, the supports came online later than they wanted, and that's why the first blood is being delayed here. The question is if they're happy with the situation. Like once again, it's pretty much dead even. No one's making big progress. You just got that feeling that EG are more happy and more comfortable with a slow play game. We're used to see so much aggression out from CDEC, yep. But it seems like throughout the series, the further we got into the series, the later they found kills, the less effective their smokes were. And we've reached a point now where we don't even have a first blood 7.5 minutes in.
Which is really uncommon for this tournament.
Yes.
Almost every single first blood has happened before the 10-minute mark. For TI5. Everyone's been looking for that early aggression, that early movement.
Most of the time, we've even had 3 kills before.
That's true.
At least, like sometimes even like 7 or 8 kills, which is a little unusual.
But the only way it's going to happen this time around is if Sumail gets this combo. He just bottled up a haste rune, goes up to full, and also gets himself a regeneration rune. So he's able to run both of them at the same time, and a hero like a Winter Wyvern is practically free gold. When you have something like this, he just needs to see Q moving around, which he doesn't. Actually, now he gets a quick glimpse of the wings. But diving underneath the tier 1 tower is always dangerous when you go up against multiple stuns. And the Clockwork's rotating, so he has his level 6 up and running. Hookshot's available, and it looks like CDEC are looking to do something, but this Naga illusion could spoil the fun.
Yeah, they're going to run into safe position before they use their first smoke. Still not using it, though.
They're back a very long way. It's like they want to have Wyvern. Yeah, they want to have Wyvern as well. So, it's probably time to have the Winter's Curse.
Radiant's top tower is under attack.
And they're going to loop themselves into the mid at the same time. EG had exactly the same thought. It's going to be smoke on smoke. The smoke will break. He's going to have that call down to Bishop. Commits the Echo Slam to ensure the kill. Meanwhile, Aggressive almost finishing up this tier 1 tower. The EG just move themselves up. The male doesn't have to jump off your sleep, but they can just be happy with denying up the tower and having the first blood go out before the 10 minute mark.
Yeah, that was really good timing. EG outnumbering them there, 5-4. With PL just being busy in the top lane. He's going to have very early boots of travel, though, if he wants to buy the time. 9:30. At the same time, I'm a little bit surprised Q didn't try to get off the Winter's Curse at least and see where if they could make anything out of it. Like, just keeping it on cooldown here, sure, it's 110 seconds to level 1, but the chance that he'll be able to use it within the next minute and a half is probably not that high. And when the smoke broke, I guess they didn't have uphill vision, because then he could have caught a 3-hero curse.
Correct.
And EG just taking advantage of their superior positioning with that smoke rotation.
The one observe ward they did have was sitting over the top rune. That's the reason why they couldn't see far enough over. To EG, it was the perfect time. The two smoked armies meeting up against each other. If CDEC were only... Do you dare say if they didn't wait for the Wyvern, they would have been there 10 seconds earlier and they probably would have been able to get into a better position. But we can judge everything from an armchair later on. Now hook shot from XC, gonna miss on Ally. On Ally. And now just back it up. Very, very simple escape. An aggressive move down to the bottom lane. There's more fun to be had here and just want to let Fear feel comfortable. And he did buy those very early BTs with the classic Mango. And even EG. Like, stacks are always wonderful. The Fear's got 3 points up in flat count, rapidly approaching his fourth point now. And the Ancient's actually failing on this stack. But there's already a lot of Granite Golems as well as Lizards and Black Dragons inside that. Fear's gonna get a big injection of money.
And if you look at the Dire side, you have a completely free-farming PL. Who has not contributed to fights yet. He's still 1,000 gold behind the enemy mid laner. That's just the first two kills. I think Samael got the first blood. He got an assist. They got all the stacks in the jungle. And this means that this investment from CDC isn't really yielding anything just yet. It's basically playing a tie game.
Dire's structures are fortified.
I think EG have some decent counters to peel, but here we go. This is the CDC we know.
Yep.
They just gather up and push this.
They just moved from tower to tower. EG saw this coming, so they just backed up. They didn't want to have a bar of it. They leave AUI to farm up the top lane so we can try and get up to his level 6. Smell adds a little bit of pressure to mid. But CDEC are just so quick at doing this that there is no reaction that can come from EG, which will result in a tier 1 tower dropping. And this is their power. Like, it's not even like the chip play you play with the Dragonite, where you attack at the tower, you slowly let it just tick out, while the other four create a little bit of troubles. Love that pop sound. Gyrocopter. When you got that many agents, the more creeps there are for the Black Cat, and the louder the sound goes.
Just in case you didn't know what was going on, you could definitely hear what's going on.
Radiant's EG gonna walk around the top of the observer ward. CDEC though are not in any real position where they can fight, but I am looking at that Dragon Knight with 1700 gold. And it does look like he's saving up for that Blink Dagger.
It's got to be Blink, and then they'll be looking for fights and pickoffs. Now the question is, with that coming out, say, around minute 14 to 15, do they have enough fighting power? There is now a drum on aggressive.
Wyvern, you didn't really want to do that. He threw down an observer ward, but it's in range of the sentry ward. So this observer ward's going to get dewarded out very quickly.
Yeah, AUI's going to find it now.
Yep. Well, they're going to give the money over to PPD. Wants to buy himself something nice. And Fear will mop up the rest of the camp while CDEC has actually become really troublesome. When they start losing Observer Wards like this, they just don't have vision across the map. Right now, there's only one Dire Observer Ward which is in existence, and it's sitting watching that top rune. That's the only one they've got. While EG have their wards a little bit more sporadically placed, so there's one that's watching the top rune, and there's one that's watching the mid lane. Both are able to see the rotations.
This has got to be one of the fastest Bloodstones of the tournament, or at least the main event. Samael gets it at, I think it was 13:35 or something like that. And of course, the reason he gets it so early is that he skipped the treads. And just that really shows you how EG are thinking in this game, right? If they wanted to fight, he would have gone for his treads buildup. But they're just playing a slow farming game. They're just looking at efficiency. Of course, Bloodstone is so good for Storm Spirit to just ramp up his farm. Even though you don't have that attack speed from the treads, it's still, you can just use Static Remnant instead and clear camps faster.
EG's coming to fight. Clockwork. He'll luckily walk himself up onto the high ground, but unfortunately for the long run, there's a Samael jump in, and the Ice Blast from PPD. Very heavy commitment just for a kill over on a Wyvern. Now, C-Deck might be happy to try and counter-initiate. You've got Hookshot also available. Dragon forms up, Laguna Blades are also available for the Lina. And the side lanes are pushing, and AUI is still hovering around on that top lane. He can just TP Song with the Siren if things get rough though. And maybe that's why C-Deck should be a little bit more cautious. Because that Song with the Siren will allow EG just to reset.
But they can't just sit back, I think. Like, they have their key items now. They have the Blink on Dragonite, they have the Drum, as well as the Boots of Travel on TL. This is when they want to fight, usually.
Yep. And they're going to. Throw down the Sentry Ward, they checked up on the hill to see if there was an Observer Ward. And now we'll move into the Radiant Jungle. The only hero they saw was Fear on the bot lane, as well as, again, this Naga Siren, who's been giving all this free space in the world on the top, just to continue to farm up the Naga.
Dire's top tower is under attack.
CDEC need a different option. They can try and have another play at mid, because they know there's no one inside the EG jungle. Garo's just going to break his smoke, and they'll just start pushing the lane now. Smoke deck fails. Back to the farm. And Aggressive's still got so much of that. He's starting up on his Diffuser Blade right now. And AUI kind of, he's not going to contest the Phantom Lancer. And PL can just keep moving everywhere. He's got these BTs, so he pushes aggressively as he wants to. And
he's actually
joined the rest of his teammates.
He's managed to catch up to Samael. He was 1,000 behind, if you remember.
He's now ahead.
He's actually ahead. So
Dire's middle tower.
They are
is
finding
under
the farm that they want on the PL, but he's the only one.
But then you've also got that embrace of the Storm Spirit that's being locked up by the curse and Laguna Blade. And this is the peril you have as a Storm Spirit, where CDEC, they've got the control and the burst damage to kill him off very quickly. And that's also Bloodstone Charge's loss. He's down to 6 now after the initial game. Touché!
Who ate a mango?
It was the Gyro.
Alright.
I think he's freeing up a spot. Yeah, we've got a Salve coming in and also the Sanj.
Dire's top tower
oh,
is
he still
under
has
attack.
His oh well. Guess he was hungry. So this ancient stack is probably going to be, I don't know if Fear wants to go
Radiant's
for it again while it's a single, or if they're
attack.
Looking for any sort of play in mid. But right now, EG are being a little bit scared here with CDEC inside their jungle. They're, as a result, just going to pressure
attack.
Out this bottom tier 2 a little bit with the remainder of their dragon form on Cheeky. And just that one kill on Storm Spirit is actually really important. It's their first kill on the board, which is something, for a little bit of momentum and just to keep the morale high, but more than anything, he is the hero they want to shut down. Even if Fear gets really good farm on the Gyrocopter, I think with this amount of single target burst that they have, especially looking at Alina, who will probably transition into an Aghanim somewhere down the line, they might be able to
off mid lane. Where's the Wyvern embracing himself for now? No regeneration, that Ice Blast. This is going to be enough to kill him off. No, it will not. So the Winter Wyvern will not shatter.
What an aggressive play, though, for Samael to just jump into the tower like that with an Ice Blast. If there was a counterplay available there from, say, a Dragon Knight or a Clockwork, that could have gone very wrong. I don't know what heroes they had seen on the map. If they know the positioning, they can, of course, just go for it just to put some pressure.
Have we even seen that Blink Dagger from the Dragon Knight
Dire's
have
top tower
any
is under attack.
Because normally
Dire's
we look for that, like, that Blink to Dragon form into Dragon Tail stun, and you catch out most heroes a long, long way out.
He's using it to farm right now. It's increasing his
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Of course. But yeah, it has to affect him.
Eyes on the bottom. He actually managed to hit aggressive with this. He already double banged away aggressive. And now Dragon Knight, there's that move. Some mana. He's got a lot of mana, but he's got himself a Haystrin. The Light Strike array not going to connect either. If it did, they may have had enough time to attack into him. But Laguna Blade to finish the job.
And this is when Aggressive has to start leveling up Doppelganger, which it looks like he is doing. Probably put the second skill point in it on level 12. And with the way these fights are going, Dyer's he needs the lower cooldown. It is really, attack. Really important.
He's almost got that Diffuser Blade done. At the same time, the T1 tower was taken on top lane. PPD's just soaking up the experience there now. Loves being on the opposite side of the map when you play the Ancient Apparition. Gives you that bigger radius for the ultimate. Considering CDEC can be pretty spaced out with their lineup, they need to be able to have that big range. But man, it really feels like though CDEC, like there's no the experience is a little bit going the way of EG. There's nothing in the column, but it's only like 4K. Oh, that's real trouble right now. The stun's gonna miss. He could turn around and try and nuke on Samal, but it's not gonna be anything good. Samal will bottle back up again. They find a pickoff, it's over on the support Lina. But EG still not addressing the major issue, which is this Phantom Lancer. An under 20 minute BT drum Diffuser Blade up for aggressive. Okay, that happened. Blink, Echo Slam, and Call Down. And the Winter Wyvern just explodes.
Dyer's
and that's also
going to
mean a
attack.
T1 tower in a bit.
Dyer's structures are fortified.
Yeah. They probably have the confidence to go for it. If Fear gets jumped here, they can just... They scout the ults, they know it's clear.
Attack. Easy tier 1.
Dyer's
very
middle
easy tier 1.
Has fallen.
So we talked about all the farm over on aggressive, but when you've got also this Gyarados walking around with SMY, Helm of the Dom, Thor Treads and Aquila, he's definitely ready to fight. Samael's actually had enough of CDEC to sit in back. Takes up a little bit of the farm with the Dire Jungle and then just jumps down to bottom lane. The clock works around here, but CDEC are just trying to avoid all fights until probably this moment when they smoke up a three. Dragon Form is up. So is Laguna Blade. They could attempt to go in for Roshan, but without the Medallion of Courage, it's going to be a very, very long time. So instead, they try and kill up Samael. The Observer Ward's watching him closely. They'll see him put down a Remnant, and they've already gone into the DK Dragon Form. So we had an instantly blink, stun, and just last right around the neck, and they'll use the curse with Laguna Blade to mail!
Oh.
Almost able to jump in the universe right in the back of Garden. They've got the call out as well, this will instantly kill off the leader. But now the Hulk shot as well, XD's looking for a good line, and he completely walks off to the side! Universe is gonna thump, and the DK's doing a lot more work, especially when the Splinter arrives in from Q. Two heroes down for EG, and the tier 2 town starting to get chipped away. Aggressive also BT'd himself down here, so they got more pressure.
There was no TP on AUI, I think. He might have used it to go top to farm, but this is the hero for EG. In case he didn't have one, you absolutely want to have a TP on the Naga to go and save a situation
Radiant's
like that.
Bottom tower is under
they might
attack.
Have figured when Samael gets jumped that they couldn't have saved him, but I think with a TP instant song there, they probably keep him alive.
There's a couple of things which are falling apart. Samael just tried to TP to the tier 1 tower and accidentally kills his TP. So he's all likely running up for Wyvern. I suppose this might make up for it. Killing off the Winter Wyvern on the hillside. But Wyvern did get the Observer Ward down as he was dying. This would be very difficult for EG to know about.
Let the fun begin!
But more and more runes now. A haste rune in for Samael. And the Observer Ward was watching Shiki moving around inside the Dire Jungle. They're actually throwing up the ulti. That's only going to hit the creep wave though. Both Garter as well as Shiki have fallen back behind their tier.
He's just using it to scout with as well. Gets a lot of vision. Doesn't really find anyone, but not finding anyone is also information, of course. Then they know there's no one in the neighborhood right there. And the farming just continues in fear. You know, this is kind of starting to remind me of, you know, Thor Open back in the day.
No,
like the...
no, not the Sven era. We did not want to go back to the Sven era.
Teams were just stacking their ancients and just farming the ancients for 30 minutes, and then whoever had Sven won. So
no Tidehunter era. That was It's good times, man. Good times.
Things have changed a little bit since then. But
they have.
That was...
EG,
they've
at least changed the tempo. We've got a haste rune already triggered over on Storm Spirit, but it's the smoke movement coming out with the rest of EG. But CDEC is not in a bad position for this. They're just around the corner, including Hookshot. So Garter, as well as Shiki, they're not liking where they are, and actually Shiki just leaves Garter for dead. He blinks himself away to safety. Shiki goes to Garter with a Hookshot in. He gets Laguna Blade over on Samael, and Samael, he's practically out of mana. The curse is on him, Universe has to come around. He's trying to kill with his own teammate. Is Universe actually going to get a double kill? He's going to kill his teammate for Clockwork. The embrace is there, the fish control, a triple kill for Universe. But now we see Aggressive coming online. The Phantom Lancer, insanely difficult to deal with. He's going to doppelganger himself in the fine PPD. He'll pick up the kill, and it'll be a 2-for-3 trade-off. And the big one for EG, losing the Storm Spirit, now down to 4 Bloodstone charges on Samael.
This is still a very even game, but EG do manage to come out of that one kill ahead. Still with Samael on the sidelines, Aggressive should be able to increase his gap down to him, but of course Fear is still finding his own. These fights closing in on a BKB. He's actually very, very close to it, just a few hundred away on the gyro.
So at least he won't have his mana burnt out.
He won't have his mana burnt, and the only real counter CDC he has is the Winter's Curse. Yes, they also have Hookshot, but someone had to kill Fear during the BKB. And a lot of PL's damage right now is coming from the feedback from the Eagle Blade. Oh, wow. Great. Great
doppelganger there.
What a great.
Unfortunately for Universe, when he jumps in, he doesn't have the Echo Slam, and that's the Insta Stun required. So there was time for Aggressive to not only see it, respond to it. Doppelganger's away, BT's up to the top lane, instantly starts flip push, while the rest of CDEC, they start attacking into the tier 1 tower. And while that PKB might be nice over on Fear, a concern which should be there for Evil Geniuses is the fact they don't really have enough damage to kill off this Phantom Lancer quick enough that their supports will survive. And maybe that's a different place we should be looking at it. The Storm Spirit's gonna get an Orc, and that's gonna be terrific, but this mana style is getting very close to completion for Aggressive. So there's no control from the Storm on that front. A lot of it relies on basically Universe hitting them up.
Yeah. They only really have one carry who's good against the PL when he has the Manta. So that is definitely true. It's not the worst matchup we've seen PL in. We've seen it winning against Gyro a couple of times in this tournament. The time it gets scary is when you're playing against Ember and Gyro or something like that. Then it can be really, really tricky, but definitely
DK, Dragon form, he's coming off of PPD. Blink, Stun, Free Fire, a quick land for the base. For PPD to at least get the ulti off. Universe wants to walk in.
Dyer's
it's actually got Blink and Echo
attack.
Slam available.
Radiant's
with a BKB up from Dragon, there's very little reason to use it. But with Storm Spirit having this fresh Orchid, who can't see the EC by surprise. Throw out more lances. Jump in. There's your curse to Mount. Going in deep over on Wily. He's already using the ability, but here comes your call out. Dragon goes there for something. Keeps Universe out. No big red land for him. Back. Universe will drop, and maybe even one after is going to get a double kill for Samael. The Song of the Siren allowing EG to reset Samael, not with a great amount of mana, but all time for them to come back off cooldown. They can control the clockwork. He will take a fall, but Aggressive is on the run. The PL will still survive, and will probably TP bottom to take up all the money there.
Samael is causing them so much trouble. He jumps in on the Wyvern, it forces out a cape, and then they just go on to the Lina as well. Never got her Laguna Blade off. Just gets completely shut down in that fight. And you just know the whole time that if things aren't going the way EG are planning, they can just Song of the Siren like they did toward the end of that fight just set up and finish it off. So they read the fight very well, but they were ahead the whole time. And they do get the clearly better exchange there as Fear once again survives the fight, gets even more. He still hasn't died this game.
So big for him being 5-0-5 on the KDA. But I'm also looking down towards a PL. He's 2-0-2. And continues to add this flip push pressure, which EG, they've got some metal to help deal with that. But again, we need to go back over what we talked about. There's no control and Aggressive that Samael can use. He definitely causes havoc with the rest of CDEC. So this PL will continue just to BT split push this game out, get more and more money, And that, for me, is still the biggest problem for Evil Geniuses. Where do you go with this? Fear needs to have that damage-dealing item. But in order to do so, he's got to drop either his TP Scroll or save the Ring of Aquila. And Samael, Blink, Gunner's going to beat you with the Hulk Shot as well. Laguna fights Samael, the Colts Burn. The Colts Burn bolt them a little bit of extra time. And with Samael down and no buyback, Roshan is a very, very juicy target here for CDEC.
Yeah, EG are going to know they're going for it, though. First of all, it would be pretty obvious from the lane situation, but they also have a good ward around the river area to see. CDEC are moving in there now. I don't think EG are interested in contesting this 4-on-5, but maybe they can delay it long enough for it to be 5-on-5 if they ice blast and trigger properly.
There is no hook shot.
They're all together. PPD, here comes the ice blast for it. Oh! In from Yuvan! It's a disaster! CDEC! They're going to get wide from the face of the earth, apart from aggressive, and jump out for the Wombo combo! Perfectly hits from Evil Geniuses! And now they will take Roshan!
Yeah, they don't even need to buy time. When they have superior vision and CDEC has no idea what's coming. Universe was so convinced, they're so sure they're in there because of the vision show they're moving down that direction, that he just blindly blink Echo Slams. Knowing that he should, oh, actually not blindly, they already put down an Ice Vortex first, actually, so they didn't know for sure they were there. But even without the Ice Vortex, I think he still would have gone for it, because the only alternative is that CDEC move toward the Roche Pit, and they actually don't go for it, baiting, expecting that EG want to check it 4-on-5, which would be very unlikely. And then just going for it instead, they just get being clumped up, get completely obliterated by the Echo Slam Ice Blast.
It's at this point I would also ask the question, where was Zedek's vision coming into that fight?
Going into Roshan blindly like that against a Shaker, Naga, and AA lineup is very, very risky. They might just be feeling the pressure that they have to get something done with every single major kill they find. But that was not the play. Roshan without vision is not good.
The only upside for him was the fact that Aggressive was able to survive. So once again, he's not giving up much of this farm, but we're still looking at the Gyrocopter now being just under 900 gold away from completing up the full butterfly. So he's looking fantastic. That's Fear. AUI was able to clean up the mech, but he's also got the Medallion of Courage. So that Solar Crest could be coming up a lot sooner as well. The Earthshaker was able to afford up an entire Glimmer Cave. And it looks like a Lincoln Sphere build coming in for Samael, who's already got the first appearance. Even PPD has his own Glimmer in and out of trouble. EG have every item that they really need at this point of the game. And CDEC, they need one hell of a fight to repair this damage of Golden Experience and keep themselves in TI5. They're the ones who are playing from a game down. They're the ones with all the pressure on them.
And once Samael gets this Lincoln Sphere, the Dragon Knight Blink Dragon Tail is not going to have any effect. He's either going to block that or say a Wizard's Curse. Pretty likely. Of course, there are other single target spells that can break the Lincolns, but I think it's really good for him in this game. It's mainly just the Dragon Knight he's getting it against to feel safer around the map. Pretty good chance he can use it as a control. Man, that works.
It's going to be one of those moments. EG could have actually won TI5 with just that moment. That's how important that dunk was. And Evil Geniuses, all they gotta do is just roll through the motions and like still be very mindful about the slip push. CDEC, if they want to, they can still keep dodging. Like Roshan was one of those special moments where EG knew where CDEC was going to. So you're able to fight him there. But this push coming into the T1 tower, there's no reason to take a 5v5 fight. You could just TP aggressive to the top lane. Keep the pressure in, and you'll take the T1 tower, yes, EG, but either you take the tier 2 tower and lose your own tier 2 tower, and you find these trade-off games.
And for now, they're just getting one for free. Yeah, this is an easy tier 1. Tower has fallen. And with Fear with Butterfly, they're not scared of a team fight. They have all their abilities off cooldown again, apart from Ice Blast coming up to 20.
CDEC might be happy to fight this.
I don't think they want to at all.
It's just because the double damage room is over on the Dragon Knight. So if EG falls it further into the tier 3 tower has fallen, then CDEC would be happy to take the engagement.
Radiance middle tower. On the other hand, they would have to wait until she gets level 16. It's 100 XP away. If he has to use Dragon Form now, that's pretty annoying for him.
Bro, you really want to do have that cost Dragon? He's got the Creek Wave, so. And Samael's already moved up to the top lane. Probably yellows down here, but he'll use as much burst damage as he can with the Rems to get rid of it. There's that full Solar Crest now up for AUI. Zap! And Lina is working on the Aghanim himself, but she had to go for the 4-star to start with.
So she... I can't help but feel like AUI is playing techies, you know? It's like, he has one assist in 34 minutes in an 18-minute game. It's just been like... He's been playing on his own, like pushing out lanes, just casually farming, getting toward the key items with both the mech and the Solar Crest, while the others have just been running around finding these kills. And he's had a really big impact, because it's been difficult for CDC to push the towers when the Naga has always been in place to defend. So it looks like he hasn't done anything when you look at the kill death assist, but it's not true. It's just, it's funny to observe how little kill participation he has had in this game.
If only the Song of the Siren did some level of damage.
Yeah.
Then you have yourself some assists.
Then you would have Naga into the first phase of every game. Oh, wait.
Snap. Tier 2 Town's going to be dropping on the top lane for CDEC. This is their last out of tower.
Dire's top tower
now going
has
down.
Fallen.
An evil genius is inching closer to victory if they can make it. But the TPs are coming back, and CDEC are ready to find this one. Hawkshot's off the drone. He's got that Dragon Knight triggering the double damage rune now. I'm also watching PL with a large amount of money. In fact, he's just spending a little bit more of it. He just put a heart recipe. It's over on the courier. If he can find another 800 gold on the map, that's the full heart in for the Phantom Lancer. But at the same time as this is happening, I'm watching Chi moving to the secret shop, and he'll pick up... Actually, he's going a defensive item. He's building into the Satanic straight away before he builds into the Monkey King bar.
It's pretty sustainable fights. I think EG feel like they don't need damage right now, and even if they see the heart on P, they still have a lot of ways to deal with it. They have Echo Slam, Ice Blast is pretty good. The spell damage of Flak Cannon and Calldown and everything, or well, the physical damage of Flak Down and Spell Flak Cannon, they have a lot. Okay, they have a lot of AoE damage to still kill the illusions off, so I don't think an MKB or something like that is necessary yet for Fear. I think he wants to wait with it until when he sees the heart, he probably knows that the next item is going to be a Butter. And that's when he wants to counter-itemize with the MKB, and they can be running around the same time. Cheaper item.
Here we go again. Regeneration. 5 minutes smoked by CDEC. They'll look for the opening on EG. Now, Samael's not in the perfect position for this. He is going to see an Invis rune and potentially going to jump down and grab it. And they can curse him up. Link is feared, though. It triggers. That wasn't the curse from Q, however. But the PL just runs himself down to EG, taking a lot of fear metal. Now, remember aggressive doesn't have to Dragon Knight lucky to survive, and he can't even get back. His TP is on cooldown. There's 32 seconds before the DK can TP back to base. He could lose his entire racks in that time.
Dire's bottom
tower
is under attack.
Tried to TP out earlier.
Attack.
This should actually be a lane. I don't know if EG are aware of this, so they might start to feel any bit of pressure, but Fear doesn't
Dire's
care right now. He is definitely up front.
Now, Dire's bottom going in deep, chasing out the Q's. They just need a couple of kills. With the Wyvern, he's down for the count. Fear, fully wicked set. They're gonna bring in Satanic as well for Fear while the push continues. As the tier 3 tower drops DK, only now is he TPing back, and he's still gonna regenerate. The melee racks will drop. EG, how much respect do you give? The PL is up in 7 seconds. They're going to rotate themselves over the tier 3 tower. They do not want to overstay their welcome here, and they may just have the confidence to keep on going with that fresh Satanic. Shiki Dragon falls up, gets the move up here. They're moving forward. Don't beat it! We keep the power going! So no money, love, or matter! We need to keep controlling Fear, DDC! Shoot the front movement!
attack.
Wants to come out and find some kind of collateral kills. But EG are turning tail and running for now. Universe is ready to turn. He's got Echo Slam up. He just got out of locked in position right now. He could embrace some battle with the wide of a few moving forward as well. DK about to drop. Aggressive on all survivor. TDEC. It looks troublesome. It looks really, really bad for them. Aggressive on the run. Universe right behind him. They keep running out, but GG will win. EG are your TI5 champions. It looks rough dropping down the lower bracket. They had to play the best of three and the best of five today. But they have persevered. And they will claim the Aegis of the Immortals.